Hello dear students, welcome back to Accountancy class. I am Shweta J from Commerce Department, Gopal Swami PU College, Mysore. In today's session, let us solve 6 mark problem based on accounting equation. Now let's solve example problem of 6 marks. Here is your example problem. Analyze the effect of each transaction on assets and liabilities and show that the both the side of accounting equation remains equal. The first transaction is introduced cash rupees 1 lakh and furniture rupees 5000. Second transaction, purchase machinery from Bell on credit rupees 50000. And the third transaction, deposited rupees 10000 into the bank. And the fourth transaction, paid cash to Bell rupees 50000. The next transaction, purchase goods of rupees 8000 for cash and for 5000 on credit. Goods amounting to rupees 5000 was sold for rupees 6000 on cash basis. Goods costing rupees 4000 was sold for rupees 6000 on credit. Issued a check to the supplier of goods rupees 2000. Now let's get started. First write the accounting equation. Assets equals liabilities plus capital. So what is the first transaction? The first one is introduced cash rupees 1 lakh and furniture rupees 5000. This transaction affects cash and furniture on the asset side of the equation, and at the same time it also affects capital on the liability side of the equation. So you should bring cash and furniture on asset side of the equation. So first you should write cash. What is the amount of cash? Rupees 1 lakh. And it also affects furniture, so you should write furniture on the asset side. What is the amount of furniture? That is rupees 5000. This transaction affects capital also on the liability side, and the amount of capital increased by rupees 1,05,000. Illi owner business anna start maadbekadre cash mate furniture anna eradu kuda investment maadidane. What is the meaning of capital? Capital means money or money's worth invested by the owner in the business. Owner business anna start maadbekadre avanu cash investment ಮಾಡಬಹುದು ಅಥವಾ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಅಸೆಟ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಇನ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗಬಹುದು. ಸೊ ಅದನ್ನ ನಾವು ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ? ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ನಾವು ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಹಿಯರ್? ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರುಪೀಸ್ 1,05,000. ವೆನ್ ಯು ಆಡ್ ಬೋತ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫರ್ನಿಚರ್, ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ದಿ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಓನರ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರುಪೀಸ್ 1,05,000. So as I said in the beginning, accounting equation must be equal. Accounting equation eradu side allu kuda equal balance varbeku, on the same balance varbeku, asset side as well as liability side. So now the total of assets of the business is 1,05,000, and the total of liability side also 1,05,000. 1,05,000, 1,05,000, and this accounting equation is also called as a balance sheet equation. Balance sheet equation antanu heltivi. And the next transaction is purchase machinery from Bell on credit rupees 50,000. So Bell company inda niven maadidira 50,000 worth machinery anna purchase maadidira. Here the composition of assets of the business gets changed. So first write down the assets. Cash 1 lakh plus furniture 5000 plus one more addition, that is machinery. What is the amount of machinery? 50,000. Here the second transaction affects machinery on the asset side. Means this transaction increases asset side by rupees 50,000. ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ರ ಬರೀ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಫರ್ನಿಚರ್ ಇತ್ತು, ಬಟ್ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಒಂದು ಮೆಷಿನರಿಯನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀರಾ, 50,000 ವರ್ತ್ ಮೆಷಿನರಿ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀರಾ, ಆದ್ರೆ ನೀವು ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಪೇಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ದ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಈಸ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟೆಡ್. ಸೊ ನೌ ದ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಈಸ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ರುಪೀಸ್ 50,000 ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಡಸಂಟ್ ಅಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ದಿ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್. ಸೊ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ರೈಟ್ 50,000 ಬಿಲೋ ದ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಪ್ಲಸ್ capital amount remains same. So now add all the assets together, you will get 1,55,000. Now the total value of assets is rupees 1,55,000, and the liability side also you will get the same balance, that is rupees 1,55,000. So now both the side getting equal. Machinery anna purchase maadidira, 50,000 worth machinery anna purchase maadidira, adre cash payment maadilla. Yavaga neevu cash payment maadalvo aga neevu liabilities under alli record maadta hogbeko. So if it is any assets purchased on credit basis, then liabilities will be created. So then you have to write the amount of purchased under the liability and capital amount remains same. The next transaction is deposited rupees 10,000 into the bank. This transaction reduces the cash balance by rupees 10,000 and creates the bank balance on the asset side. Cash, what is the amount of cash now? 1 lakh plus we have furniture also. What is the amount of furniture? 5,000, and we have machinery also. What is the amount of machinery? That is rupees 50,000. And now this transaction create bank balance also. How much you deposit in the bank? That is rupees 10,000. And liabilities capital remains same. So now the total of assets is rupees 1,55,000. When you add all the assets together, you will get 1,55,000. Then when you add both liabilities and capital, you will get the same total of rupees 1,55,000. When you deposit cash into the bank, then you have to deduct amount of deposit from the cash balance, and at the same time it creates bank balance. So neevu yavaga cash inna bank ge deposit maartira aga cash balance kadme agate, bank balance create agate. Bank is also considered as an asset to the business. The next transaction is paid cash to Bell rupees 50,000. So iga Bell company ke nave en maartta idivi 50,000 anna pay maartta idivi. So now this transaction affects cash on the asset side and liabilities on the other side of the equation. So iga Bell company ke cash anna pay maartta idira anta heladre cash alli kadme agutte, hage liabilities will become nil. Fourth transaction is cash paid to Bell. So now we have to deduct amount of purchased rupees 50,000. 50,000 anna naven Bell company ke pay maadbekagitto adana neevu ivaga illi minus maadbeku. 90,000 minus 50,000, 40,000. So now the cash balance in the business is rupees 40,000. But it doesn't affect any changes in any other asset. It remains same. Write the same amount. 40,000. What is the amount of furniture? 5,000 plus 50,000. And we have bank balance also. The amount of bank balance is rupees 10,000. Now the liabilities will become nil. And capital amount remains same, 1,05,000. So now add all the assets together, you will get 40,000 plus 5,000 plus 50,000 plus 10,000, 1,05,000. And on the liability side also, total amount is 1,05,000. Now the accounting equation gets tally. The next transaction is purchase goods of rupees 8,000 for cash and for 5,000 on credit. This transaction reduces the cash by rupees 8,000 and creates liabilities by rupees 5,000 and the stock by rupees 13,000. Let me show you how to write this equation. So now the current cash balance is rupees 40,000. New previous transaction alli yen changes maadirthira adanne carry maartta hogbeku. So now the present cash balance is rupees 40,000. Goods purchased for cash rupees 5,000. 5,000. So when you purchase goods for cash, then you have to deduct the purchase value from the cash balance. So you cash basis ali purchase maardaga cash balance inda you deduct maarta hogbeko. Minus 8,000, you will get 32,000. So now this is the current cash balance. Plus we have furniture. The value of furniture is 5,000. We have machinery. The value of machinery is rupees 50,000. And we have bank balance also. And the bank balance is rupees 10,000. Now, when you purchase goods, then it increases stock on the asset side. Yavaga neevu goods anna purchase maartira, aga stock anna asset create aagta hogutte. So you have to write stock on the asset side. What is the value of stock you have purchased? That is rupees 8,000 plus 5,000. So 8,000 anna cash basis ali purchase maadidira and credit basis mele 5,000 goods astu purchase maadidira. So total value of goods purchased is rupees 13,000. So now you have the total value of goods worth rupees 13,000. So out of 13,000, 8,000 worth goods purchased on cash basis and 5,000 goods purchased on credit basis. So when you purchase goods on credit basis, liabilities will be created. So how much amount of liability here created? That is rupees 5,000. You have to write below the liabilities as rupees 5,000 plus the capital amount remains same. So now add all the assets together, 32,000 plus 5,000 plus 50,000 plus 10,000 plus 13,000. Now the total value of the assets is rupees 1,10,000. When you add liabilities plus capital, you will get the same balance of rupees 1,10,000. So now both the side, that is asset side as well as liability side, gets tallied. So eradu side kuda tally agide and eradu side kuda namge equal balance bandide. So this is how we show the transaction in the form of accounting equation. The next transaction is, I repeat, goods purchase maadidira, 13,000 worth goods anna purchase maadidira, adalli 8,000 cash basis alli, 5,000 credit basis alli. 8,000 cash basis alli purchase maadirodrinda nimmalli iruvanta 40,000 cash alli 8,000 kadame agutte. So iga current cash balance is to 32,000. Furniture business ala hage ide, machinery hage ide, bank balance 10,000 hage ide, eno changes agila, stock create agide, yakandre ivaga neevu purchase maadidira, total worth is to 13,000. Neevu cash basis alladru purchase maadi, credit basis alladru purchase maadi, total value of goods purchased is rupees 13,000. That must be considered in accounting equation. And the next, on the liability side, liability increased by rupees 5,000 and the capital amount remains same, that is rupees 1,05,000. The next transaction is, goods amounting to rupees 5,000 was sold for rupees 6,000 on cash basis. 5,000 worth iro goods anna 6,000 ge sale maadta idira. So 6,000 ge sale maadadaga 1,000 astu namge profit agutte. Yavaga business ke profit agutte aa 1,000 anna capital ge add maadbeku. Now I will show you how to record this transaction in accounting equation. Transaction number 6. So cash basis alli neevu goods anna sale maadta irodrinda 6,000 cash anna neevu nimma cash balance ge add maadbeku. You have to add 6,000 to the cash balance. 32,000 plus 6,000, 38,000. Plus there is no changes in furniture. We have furniture. So write the same amount of furniture. There is no changes in machinery. Also write the same balance. There is no changes in bank balance. Write the same bank balance. But there is some changes in stock. Goods amounting to rupees 5,000 was sold for rupees 6,000 on cash basis. Namatra total worth goods is today. We have 13,000 worth of goods. Out of 13,000 worth of goods, we have sold 5,000 worth goods to the customers. So that we have to deduct 5,000 worth goods from the total of 13,000. 13,000 in the 5,000 goods anna deduct maadbeku. 13,000 minus 5,000 you will get 8,000. Nimada 13,000 goods ide adralli 5,000 worth goods anna sale maadta idira. ಹಾಗಾದರೆ ಈಗ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ವರ್ತ್ ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ ಎಷ್ಟಿದೆ, ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಎಷ್ಟಿದೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ರ ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ 8,000 ಇದೆ. ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಇನ್ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಫೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಸೈಡ್ ವಿಚ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ದಿ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಬೈ ರುಪೀಸ್ 1,000. ಸೊ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಆ್ಯಡ್ 1,000 ಟು ದಿ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್. 1,05,000 ಪ್ಲಸ್ 1,000 you will get 1,06,000 because there is a profit to the business by selling goods. 5,000 worth iro goods anna 6,000 ge sale maadidira. So aga nimge 1,000 profit agutte. Yavaga profit agutte that profit amount should be added to the capital amount on the other side of the equation. So capital ge neevu 1,000 anna add maadbeku. So when you add all the assets together you will get 1,11,000. On the liability side, when you add liabilities plus capital, you will get 1,11,000. 5,000 plus 1,06,000, you will get 1,11,000. And the next transaction is goods costing rupees 4,000 was sold for rupees 6,000 on credit. This transaction reduces the stock by rupees 4,000 and creates the debtors by rupees 6,000 on the asset side, and as well as it also increases the capital by rupees 2,000 for the profit. 4,000 iro goods anna 6,000 ge sale maadta idivi as on credit basis. Credit basis alli sale maadta irodrinda it is not at all affected the cash balance. So now cash balances is rupees 38,000. So there is no changes in the furniture also. Write the same amount 5,000. Machinery also 50,000. And there is no changes in bank balance. Write the same amount. But there is changes in stock. We have 8,000 worth goods. Out of 8,000 we have sold 4,000 worth goods to the customer. 8,000 as to goods ittu namatra adralli 4,000 worth goods anna sale maadidivi. So you have to deduct 4,000 from the 8,000. You will get 4,000. And this transaction creates debtors of rupees 6,000. Goods anna neevu ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಬೇಸಿಸಲ್ಲಿ ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಡೆಟಾರು ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಡೆಟಾರನ್ನು ನಾವು ಅಸೆಟ್ ಅಂತ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ರೆಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಅಸೆಟ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಈಕ್ವೇಷನ್. ಸೊ ಡೆಟಾರ್ಸನ್ನು ಅಸೆಟ್ ಸೈಡಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ರೆಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತೀರಾ. ಸೊ ನಾವು 38,000 ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್, 5,000 ಫರ್ನಿಚರ್, 50,000 ಮೆಷಿನರಿ, 10,000 ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟಾಕ್ 4,000, ಡೆಟಾರ್ಸ್ 6,000. And there is no changes in liability, but you have to add 2,000 profit to the capital amount as usual. 2,000 add martira, then you will get 1,08,000. So now when you add all the assets together, you will get 1,13,000. On the liability side, you will get 1,13,000. ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಬೇಸಿಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಡೆಟಾರ್ಸ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಡೆಟಾರ್ಸ್ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿ ರೆಕಾರ್ಡೆಡ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಅಸೆಟ್ ಸೈಡ್. ವೆರ್ ಆಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಬೇಸಿಸ್ ದೆನ್ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ರೆಕಾರ್ಡೆಡ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಸೈಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಅಕೌಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಈಕ್ವೇಷನ್. ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಬೇಸಿಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಡೆಟಾರ್ಸ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಆ ಡೆಟಾರ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಅಸೆಟ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ರೆಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಬೇಸಿಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಅದು ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಅಂಡರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ರೆಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗಬೇಕು ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಅನ್ನ. ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಶ್ಯೂಡ್ ಅ ಚೆಕ್ ಟು ದಿ ಸಪ್ಲೈಯರ್ ಆಫ್ ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ ರುಪೀಸ್ 2000. ದಿಸ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ದಿ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಅಫೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಸೈಡ್, ವಿಚ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ದಿ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಸೊ ನಾವ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ 38,000 ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಇನ್ ಫರ್ನಿಚರ್, ರೈಟ್ ದಿ ಸೇಮ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಮೆಷಿನರಿ 50,000, ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ 10,000, ಸ್ಟಾಕ್ 4,000, debtors 6,000. This transaction mainly affects the bank balance, so you have to make a changes in bank balance only. Bank balance al matra neevu change martta hogtira. Yen neevu goods purchase madidira credit basis mele avarge 2000 worth check ana neevu issue martta idira. So hagagi nimma bank balance inda minus madbeko. 10,000 minus 2000, you will get 8,000. And at the same time it also reduces the liabilities. 5,000 minus 2,000, you will get 3,000. And the capital amount remains same, that is rupees 1,08,000. Previous transaction alli yen bardirthira adune copy maadi 1,08,000. Now add all the assets together. 38,000 plus 5,000 plus 50,000 plus 4,000 plus 6,000. When you add all the assets together, you will get 1,11,000. And on the liability side also, you will get same balance, 1,11,000. So this is how we prepare accounting equation. So accounting equation anna neevu prepare maadbeku anta heladre, so yen previous transaction record maadirthira aa previous transaction annu kuda consider maartha hogbeku. You have to consider previous transaction for recording the current transaction. Current transaction record maadbeku anta heladre previous transaction annu kuda consider maadi previous transaction alli enella changes aagirutte adanna nodkondu current transaction anna record maartha hogtira. So I hope you have understood today's session. Thank you.